In today's episode of Popular Science, we are going to be doing breakdown of my last couple movies that I filmed with Blackmagic Pocket 4K camera using DJI Ronin and Origami LUTs. I'm going to show you guys exactly how I colored it in DaVinci Resolve, and we're going to talk a little bit about some of the scenes inside. If you guys subscribe to my channel, please hit notification bell, because lately YouTube been completely squeezing me with their algorithm. They no longer suggesting my videos, and that's been taking a huge toll on my channel. So if you're a subscriber, please hit that notification bell. If you're not, please consider subscribing. That helps a lot of me making videos more frequently with more quality content. Okay, so we're inside DaVinci Resolve, and as I promised you guys, I'm gonna do a breakdown of my recent couple films, one fashion movie and the one at the desert with the creepy swings. Anyways, I'm gonna tell you the exact process, how I went doing this, and basically how I colored entire thing. So I load up all the raw files. I shot those with 3:1 compression with the Blackmagic Pocket. We can see they're all flat over here. And in order for me to see a little bit more color while I edit, I like to see basically editing kind of as a final product of it. So we see log over here. So what I've done, I went, and whenever you see 3D monitor video lookup table, basically, I loaded my Origami LUT and converted everything to very nice Rec 709. And the footage immediately looks like Arri Alexa. Very nice, very cinematic. So that allowed me to have better vision, how to color everything better down the line. So once I finished editing everything, once I was satisfied how things look, I start color grading. Now, here's a very interesting trick that I want to share with you guys to make sure that you understand the process. If we go back to 3D video monitor, even though we see colors right now, when we're going to render, those colors are not going to be baked in the rendering. So this only good for editing window. Okay. So here I have to deselect everything. And instead, in the 3D output lookup table, now I have to select my Origami LUT for Blackmagic. And as you can see, nothing changed. However, if I'm going to render this clip right now, we're going to see everything we see on the screen basically going to be final. So as far as the color grading, everything was very simple, straightforward. What you can see here, that the only adjustment I've done was pretty much just adjusting the offset. If I'm going to go before and after really quick, we can see that originally it's a little bit too bright. So what I've done using offset wheel, I kind of dropped the exposure a little bit and made everything basically normalized the exposure. For example, in this shot, I have absolutely nothing going on. It's just a straight Origami LUT on top of it, and we already got that nice cinematic look of this. Very nice colors, kind of Alexa looking, very cool. So most of my colors, how I did that was entire thing, only thing I was adjusting, just exposure, and these shots, again, nothing was adjusted. This over here, exposure. This one, I had to do a little bit masking on the car because that Dodge Challenger, I believe, in the back, it was so saturated. The red color of that car was so kind of weird. I had to bring it down a little bit with the mask, and I tracked the mask so we can see it's sort of there, muted a little bit. Okay, as far as these shots over here, again, same thing, nothing really extreme over here. As you can see, originally was a little bit too bright for my flavor, so I brought everything down and made it look very nice and cinematic with that Origami LUT. Here is the same thing. We can see basically everything just an exposure. In this shot, for example, nothing. We see just a pure LUT. By the way, I did design this LUT to make kind of look like Alexa, very high-end. So you can see yourself, the colors look very nice and rich. So very fantastic how Blackmagic camera can actually deliver this kind of image to the masses for such a low price. I think it's unbelievable. So for this project, basically, there's, again, nothing really crazy going on. Everything I was doing just straight up offset. There's no secondaries or anything like that. It's all very straightforward. So now I'm going to switch and show you how I did color grading for the Lost in Time. And Lost in Time have a little bit different approach. Over here, I had to do a little bit secondaries and a little bit noise reduction in some shots for the reason that I was going to add, well, I actually added a little bit of grain. And in my experience, especially with the Blackmagic camera, we can see a little bit fine grain over here. Whenever you want to add grain later, make sure that you're working with the cleanest file, because Blackmagic footage is very notorious for having a lot of chroma artifacts. Anyways, to the actual grading. Again, grading over here is pretty straightforward. There's nothing really extreme going on. Again, I was using my origami LUT over here to convert log into nice Rec 709. Actually, this LUT can go all the way to P3 and even above. I'm working on right now making it Rec 2020. So this was exposure. This was, I believe, I added a little bit of white balance. Even like that looks cool, but I wanted to add a little bit blue, that way it looks a little bit more interesting instead of having like very monochromatic color. So this is the LUT, and after the LUT, I added a little bit kick, a little bit contrast, and here we have a noise reduction with the neat video. So here is kind of same thing. I had to do a little bit stabilization on some of the shots. And by the way, I've shot this whole thing actually with Olympus 12 to 40 between F16 and F22. I wanted to capture as much details and everything in the shot without having anything blur in the background. However, there's one downside of that. Whenever you shoot like that, image becomes a little bit soft. So make sure to keep that in mind if you're going to do something like that. So all those people saying that Micro Four Thirds is not like shallow enough, to me, this is nonsense. I mean, we're looking at F16 right now and look how shallow the background looks. I think it looks fantastic. So I really love how Pocket 4K actually captures everything. Very Alexa-like camera. Very nice and easy to work with. So over here, we have this shot right here, and here because the exposure was changing, actually I was shooting this one already when the sun started going down, I had to pump up a little bit of exposure back because things start getting a little bit dark, and I had to correct a little bit skin tone. Let me do full screen. Okay, you see the original skin was a little bit more red because the sun was very strong and orange, and I didn't want it to overpower that, so I had to compensate for that. And then again over here, basically we have just a contrast, and this thing right here is just a slightly extra kick of blue in the background. So let me show you full screen. So before and after, you can see just a tiny bit extra blue. This shot really nice over here, swings in the water, very dramatic, actually kind of eerie too. So as you can see, there's all kinds of different times that I was filming this. Sun was dropping so quickly that about 20 minutes after I shot this, the sun was already like that, and we can see that it's already completely different look. So I wanted to make sure that with the grading I kind of show, you know, I didn't want it to make them look very similar. So that was basically the little process behind. Okay, let's see this shot right here. Actually, this is an interesting shot. I had to bring down a little bit of skies to compensate for more dynamic range, because, you know, Blackmagic only has 13 stops, and I wanted to give a little bit more expensive feel to that, so I used secondaries and I brought down skies and I kind of painted a little bit to make it look like it's all nice in one shot. But besides that, this is original shot, very nice again, and this one after color grading again looks very nice and cinematic. So that's about it with both projects. There's nothing really complex of color grading this. If you guys want, leave the comments below with your questions. I might be doing different color tutorials on the already existing footage. I might do something different to kind of show you different things you can do with that. And that's about it. Stay tuned, there's lots more tutorials coming out very, very soon. I've been busy with a couple of projects, so I didn't really have too much time to pump them. Anyways, be sure to check it out, Origami Lot, link below in the description, as well as all the things I used, everything in the description, my equipment, the computer, and all the components that I use. Anyways, take care.